That's why we roll out draw. Thank you, sir.
Also, thank you for the opportunity to greet you. And this is my second time here. I've been here through the back door before. But this is the first time I'm meeting many of you as parishioners. Let us pray. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Father, we thank you for the opportunity to visit the Anglican Church of the Amazing Grace by your son and servant, whom you have put in the Baptist diocese as our father and leader. We thank you for joining us. We thank you because we have met your people here with joy and gladness. We pray that this visit will bring forth new things in our midst here in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We pray, Heavenly Father, that as this joins a people, it will be for progress.
Amen.
It will be for development.
Amen.
It will be, O Lord God, for progress. Amen. Both physically and spiritually in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We pray, Lord God, that you will assist us by your grace.
Amen.
That we will all work together for the expansion of your kingdom.
Amen.
And doing so, Heavenly Father, on the last day, none of us will miss heaven.
Amen.
In the name of God the Father,
Amen.
God the Son,
Amen.
And God the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
To God be the glory, praise be as God. Oh,
The vicar of this church and all fathers in God here present, people of God from Church of the Ascension and our people in the Church of the Amazing Grace, I salute all of you in the name of Jesus Christ, and I rejoice greatly to be privileged to be here again after a long time. And I want to thank God for our outing yesterday, which has revealed so many things to us, so many good things, and so many wonderful ways that the Lord has used and is using members of the Ascension in not only fortifying the vision, but also by the same time making expansions here and there. I pray that God in His divine majesty will not forget you. He will continue to reward the service to His glory and honor. Amen. It's been a long time that I've taken here. And coming in here today, the view is amazing. Not only the view, but the view. This project here is something that is just magnificent, even though it's not been completed. But one can visualize what it will finally look like. So I want to commend the efforts of you members of the Church of the Amazing Grace for working steadily for the Lord, for committing funds to the development of the Church of God here. And let me remind that this is a neat and well laid out church. Beautiful, neat, and of you to say that. The surroundings are okay, beautiful, tidy. So much that one would want to just sit here all day under the open heavens and enjoy the fresh air. The Church of God must continue to march on, because the Church of God, it's not a monument, it is a movement. Once it becomes a monument, then it's dying and dying. And the only way to make the church a movement is to continually seek for the lost and bring them into the fellowship of Jesus Christ, which is this building. And also to make sure that we are not stationary in our worship and activities. If you want to see how troublesome or how palaver can rear its head in any church, look at what is happening externally in the church. It is that they don't have any challenge in terms of infrastructural development. The money is there, but nothing to be used for. You'll find that the doctors always have crisis. But once a church has an infrastructural development, they have something ongoing and doing, and members can see where their funds is being channeled to, and which of course God will continue to replace, then that church will be swimming in peace. Come with me. So I'd like to commend you all here, and to thank God that the spirit of ascension under God is the same spirit in the Amazing Grace. Secondly, let me thank the Church of the Amazing Grace, because I did not consult you before linking you up to Ascension and the Divine. You see, God is very great. He has a lot of given powers unlimited to bishops. So that when we continue to teach God, I know I have an advantage that my chancellor is in that Church of the Ascension. So I have the freedom and security that if you want to take me up, you will know automatically my chancellor will be on my side. For me, that as a name, no leader should do anything in the flesh. It must regularly be in consultation with the divine. So this arrangement is in consultation with the divine. It is not out of any selfish interest. It is not out of placing body on any church. But like I said yesterday, if there is one church that I believe are a church that is practicing the Bible, Ascension is one church. That gives me joy. It gives me peace. That when as a leader we say, we are going to do this, from the scriptural background, you already know the meaning. And you already know that. The shepherd will lead and the sheep will follow. This is not to say blindfoldedly the sheep must always follow. At the time that the sheep must say, Babalika, come. This one, look at them, put it in a place. And we'll reason together. So today we rejoice that we are in yet another beautiful church, like Church of the Ascension. Beautiful environment, great project. And I believe, the last time I came here, I said this church must be pregnant and must give birth to a church. I want to believe that that is already happening.
Yes, sir.
And of course, the issue is talking of people because you go out of our room. Everybody, do not believe that in the next 15, 20 years you can be a mandatory headmistress?
Yes.
It's possible. So, the future is now. We must evangelize, seriously. We must move up. These environments daily expand.